waiting. For the end to tell me the beginning, so I know what to do right now. Is time an illusion maintained only by the urge to be told a story? Fuck that noise.
Hey, baby.
Hi, Harry. What you doing?
The usual.
Yeah, the usual. You know, you sit here all day and you drink and you pop these fucking pills because you only care about yourself. That's all you've ever cared about.
What the hell do you mean? I drink because I don't care about myself. I drink because maybe I want to kill myself.
Bullshit. You're just a big fucking baby.
Yeah, well, go fetch this baby another bottle. You hate me because you love me. But you only love me because you never loved yourself. So where does that get us? The same place.
She doesn't hear me. But maybe I mumbled it. Shit, maybe I only thought it. You hate me because you love me, but you only love me because you never loved yourself. Churches, fast food joints, rich Zen gardens with drunks sitting outside the walls. Twitching hips of radioactive pimps leaping under lampposts. Speed addicts with accelerated lifespans become senile at 30. And drift utterly confused.
Oh, brother! Brother, listen. Could you please spare some change?
I don't have shit.
What are you talking about? I just heard a jingling in your pockets.
That's my keys, man. I used to give change. Then later I'd see the bum down in the alley drinking my wine, and I'm thinking, hell, that's what I was going to spend it on.
Put your fucking hands up.
Cops with their stiff posture, as if their spines have been starched.
So, let me ask you this question, big guy. What'd you do last night?
The usual.
You know Carlo Vinyman?
I don't even know myself, nor would I want to.
He sounds pretty fucking remorseless. I say we take this fuck down to the station. Look at me. Did you do this? Did you do it?
Jesus Christ, get him the fuck out of here. He's thrown up all over.
The other suspects are all kids. I don't recognize any of them.
So why'd you do it? You kill a lady.
Does that get you fucking hard or something?
You know what, Harry? I can't understand this. How's a scumbag like you end up on a party full of college kids? I'm baffled by it.
I know how. You're a fucking dealer, right? Right? And you're a fucking pervert, too. Ain't you? Fucking pervert.
Harry, you know what those kids out there said about you? They said you were stepping in and out all night long. Do you have an answer for that? Do you have an answer for that?
Why don't the fuck you just admit it already, huh?
Like I said, I don't remember a damn thing about last night.
I start to think that I should have at least made something up. The truth is no kind of alibi, because I don't even know the truth. Is time only sustained by the urge to be told a story? Fuck that noise.
Harry, you know what? Today's your fucking lucky day. You're free to go. Go. Get the fuck out of here.
Shit. It's almost dark. Those fucking pigs. I'm dry. Linda's stuff is gone. I guess she finally flew. Good for her. There's only three reasons that full-grown men sit in a parked car for very long. One, they're smoking some weed. Two, they're giving each other hand jobs. Or three, they're watching for someone. There's no heavy breathing on the windows. They definitely want to see. Their posture is stiff, as if their spines have been starched. These ain't no gangbangers. These are coffee and donut watchers. As always, there's only one window with the lights on at this time of night. It's the room of the bugs, a pack of meth heads led by a dealer named Miles. Bugs are often up for weeks at a time, which itself can bring on paranoia, let alone the effects of the crank itself. Eventually, the brain begins to rebel against the lack of sleep and begins to dream while it's still awake. The bugs are scatterbrains, shapeshifters, time travelers. It's just like the theory of relativity. At high speeds, you can transcend space and time. In the mind, at least.
Is it?
Hey, Miles, it's me.
Do you live here? I don't know you. Who let you in the building?
Remember when I threw up outside your window and it dripped down the building?
Yo, the drunk from downstairs. Hey, I know you.
I don't even know myself, nor would I want to.
Miles is the head witch doctor on this drive, selling sweet dreams and crushed powder.
Hey, man, you want some glass?
Nah, I'm a downers kind of guy. You know that?
I know some freaky bitches, how about that?
Nah, come on.
Let's suck your dick, do your dishes, scrub your toilet.
Whores? Nah, that sounds like a crime of passion. There's one thing I'm lacking lately, it's passion. Nah, man. I'm not here for a favor. Came here to do you a favor. Don't look now. I think the cops have this place locked.
Really? Where?
In a car. Down the street.
Get away from that window, you stupid bitch! Every time you try and help someone, this is what happens. Vice squad on my ass like a motherfucking dog sniffing my crotch.
Well, I just thought you should know.
I'm always bad at this. I have to focus. Slap, snap, bump knuckles together. All right, I'm off. Linda's stuff is gone. I guess she finally flew. Good for her. Is time only sustained by the urge to be told a story? Fuck that noise. Just drinking and watching everything fuzz together. Waiting for eternity to condense into the present. Waiting for the end to tell me the beginning so I know what to do right now. They're off to make another nest somewhere. Spiraling out. And to think of those four cops in their car. They're just wasting their time now. Just like they wasted my time today. Symptoms of a wasted life. I wonder what their lead was. Why did they let me go? But shit, maybe I did it. Or maybe somebody else did it, and I only dreamt it because I saw the body on the stairs. Fuck that noise.
My brain feels dead inside this skull. The skeleton man was right after he told me we all dream in black and white. I've had neither drama nor comedy in my visions of midnight. And after watching the harsh reality of my mother's daily life, I feel selfish for being so bold as to tell her what's wrong and what's right. But maybe I'm over-dramatizing the position that I'm in. I can still breathe, and even through my thrashing I can still sleep at night. And maybe it's all in the mind of a skeleton man that feeds on misery and tries to rub off his gray days on to me, who used to look past the storm clouds with pinholes of blue gas and yellow rays of radiant sunlight. But I'll thank him anyway, 'cause I beat him at his own game tonight.
So, big guy, what'd you do all your life?
What? Is this real?
Hey, we'll ask the questions. You'll tell us what's real. So tell me, what's better? Blood or wine?
Donna, won't you blow your heart? Donna, won't you blow your home?
Yeah,
there's
Linda's in this movie.
Oh. The change in your belly.
We're having Mary's birthday party. We were invited to.
Art or memory?
Harry, now is the time, buddy. You're free to go.